Now will you notice, he goes on to say, he says in verse 19, who knoweth whether he shall be a wise man or a fool? That is, a godly man or a godless man that'll take what you have made. Yet shall he have rule over all my labor wherein I've labored, and wherein I have showed myself wise under the sun. This is also vanity. Solomon said to work for it and then turn it over to someone that's a fool. He says it's a waste of time. Verse 20, therefore I went about to cause my heart to despair of all the labor which I took under the sun. Anything you do under the sun, you see, this is the wisdom of the man under the sun. He's apart from God. This is not the man seated in the heavenlies in Christ Jesus. This is under the sun, away from God. And pessimism is the outcome, always is. And it has to be here. And that's what it is. Verse 23, for all his days are sorrows, and his travail grief, yea, his heart taketh not rest in the night. This is vanity. And Solomon found out something else. Didn't do you any good to worry about it, because there's nothing you can do about it, my friend. Couldn't then. I think you can today. Now, verse 24. There is nothing better for a man than that he should eat and drink, and that he should make his soul enjoy good in his labor. This also I saw that it is from the hand of God. For who can eat, or who else can hasten hereunto more than I? For God giveth to a man that is good in his sight wisdom and knowledge and joy, but to the sinner he giveth travail to gather and to heap up, that he may give to him that is good before God. This also is vanity and vexation of spirit. If you're just living today, just for self, even if you're God's man, and if you're a sinner, living for self, it'll come to naught. It will finally be bitterness in your heart, and it'll be bitterness in your mouth even, and it'll be nothing in the world, but you'll hold just bitter, dead leaves in your hands. That'll be life for you.